Hi, Dr. Huntington here. In this video, we're going to look at the connection between your gut, that's your small and large intestine, and your brain, specifically as it relates to attention. Now, there's more and more research coming out every year that demonstrates just how strong that connection really is. In fact, many researchers call the gut the second brain, and for good reason. Embedded in the wall of your gut is your enteric nervous system. And this system contains literally hundreds of millions of neurons. And it's becoming clear that this system is part of a two-way communication pathway, where your brain's activity is influencing the microbes in your gut. And the microbes in your gut are influencing your brain, because they make neurotransmitters and metabolites that actually act on your brain. So, although that might not be the most comforting piece of information that you've learned today, it's nevertheless true, because you've got trillions of microbes in your gut, and they are influencing your brain. So taking steps to care for them in the environment that they're living in, which is your gut, is very smart, and actually is vital to maintaining your mental health, and overall health for that matter. So one of the most common diagnoses given to a situation where a person has trouble focusing or has trouble with attention is ADHD, which stands for Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder. Now, it happens to be the most commonly diagnosed mental disorder in children, although people of all ages can be labeled with that condition. The symptoms that typically lead to this diagnosis have to do with mood or behavior. And some examples are like problems with focus, impulse control, or agitation and anxiety. Now, there's likely many contributing factors to these sorts of symptoms, but one thing is absolutely clear to any doctor that uses nutrition to help their patients, and that's that these sorts of symptoms can be caused by what you eat or problems in your gut. So if you've been labeled as ADHD or you have mental or emotional problems, you'll find that you feel a lot better and maybe your symptoms will completely resolve when you handle your diet and the health of your gut. Okay, from a dietary standpoint, here's what you need to do. First, get off all sugar, because high sugar foods and starchy carbs wreak havoc on your gut and also cause excessive insulin release. And this results in inflammation. And that, of course, leads to poor nutrient absorption. And it's this lack of the proper vitamins and minerals and enzymes that can lead to mental and emotional problems. Another dietary factor is mercury in food, particularly seafood. You need to make sure that when you eat seafood, it's seafood that tends to have low amounts of mercury, or hopefully none at all. And heavy metals in general have been found to trigger symptoms in people with ADD or ADHD. So opt for salmon and shrimp rather than the larger fish that are known for containing heavy metals, such as swordfish or tuna. Another factor is avoiding gluten. You know, the gluten-free diet is not a fad. It's really something you should consider as a lifetime habit. Most people have some degree of sensitivity to gluten. And of course, I haven't tested everybody, but that's based on thousands of patient tests that myself and other doctors have done. Now, gluten is not good for anyone, whether you're sensitive or not, because it affects the lining of your gut. Now, gluten has also been linked to numerous neurological conditions, including ADHD. Another thing you need to do is eat plenty of healthy fat. Omega-3 fats actually fuel the brain, and most people are not getting enough omega-3s. You can handle this by eating more salmon, snacking on walnuts. You can even throw walnuts on your salad, of course, like you throw the salmon on your salad also. And also include flax and chia seeds in your smoothies. Those will all help you, you know, increase the healthy fats that you're eating. Now, another factor is making sure that your food does not contain dyes. You know, make sure you read the labels, because food coloring and chemical additives tend to worsen ADHD symptoms. Now, in terms of overall food purchasing and ordering, you know, you want to make sure that you're choosing organic food whenever possible, because pesticides are directly related to brain disorders that affect behavior. And of course, your organic food is going to be free of those things, or at least have much less of those pesticides on them. And lastly, make sure to supplement your diet with high-quality dietary supplements. The key ones that really support mental and emotional problems, or I should say mental and emotional health, are fish oil, vitamin D. Make sure your D is with K2. You always want to make sure you take vitamin D with K2. Magnesium, all your B vitamins, particularly B12, and probiotics. So make sure you include those five in your diet, particularly if you're worried about mental or emotional issues, because they'll support your brain function from a nutritional standpoint. Okay, so the big takeaway here is this: an unhealthy gut will lead to poor brain function and negatively influence behavior. And anyone who's experiencing symptoms of ADHD should be extra diligent in maintaining a healthy diet and a healthy gut. Take high-quality vitamins to help fill in the gaps left by an imperfect diet. I mean, none of us are perfect. But even if you're close to perfect, you have to take into consideration the fact that the food we're eating is imperfect. You know, and so your dietary supplements are going to help fill in those gaps. Okay, so if you have friends or family, particularly children who are struggling with mental or emotional problems, please share this video as it might unlock some mysteries for them. Okay, thanks for watching.